Believe it or not, it was just 30 minutes that I walked away with the gear up and running. When I returned, there was no power, no light, but the smell of burned electronics in the air. At first, I thought the 5150 had failed me again, but no, it turned on. Instead, it obviously was the CRT which gave up and played dead on me. The question is, can I fix it using this recap kit? Retrocomputing is the use of older computer hardware and software in modern times. I'm the vintage collector, and these are my stories. I'm starting by dismantling the 5153 monitor. I had been there already during a previous run when I was cleaning it out, though I had not expected that I would see the inside of the monitor that soon again. This time over, I will be dismantling it as much as possible to do the capacitor swap out. As always, I will keep track of dismantled screws by grouping them up using paper tape and written annotations. This will simplify the reassembly later on. The first thing to remove is the connector's housing before I can gain access to the power supply unit. The power supply is housed in the second, larger cage. I have to fully disassemble it to gain access to the PCB. Again, I took some pictures for better documentation, especially for the orientation of the connectors. On first sight, there seems to be nothing unusual. However, on a closer look, there is this goo around the larger capacitors. I'm not sure yet if that is glue or actual residue from leakage. See though the left-hand capacitor. It has a bulge, which surely is no good sign. And here again a close-up, again with that residue. To me, it looks like leakage. Just when I wanted to start swapping out the capacitors, I realized that the caps contained in the kit were not 100% accurate as far as their voltage specs goes. It's totally okay to substitute a higher voltage spec capacitor, though for the almost 40 caps, this makes it hard to match up against the parts list. So I went down to match up all capacitors and label them, so I would definitely have all the correct ones assigned. And as you can see here, quite a few have been substituted by higher voltage ones. With the caps fully sorted, I can now finally start the PSU repair. Basically, it's just soldering work, removing the old caps and putting new ones in. As far as that residue goes, I will have to give it some cleaning. And here's a close-up of one of those larger caps, which shows clear signs of leakage. For the PSU, a total of 7 caps need to be replaced to make it hopefully working again. Before I'm going to touch the mainboard, I will quickly discharge the CRT for safety reasons. At the time of filming, my CRT was sitting idle for a few weeks already, so it was unlikely to still have any charge, but safe is safe. Hook up a ground wire to the main ground of the CRT and some flat screwdriver. Then you reach underneath the suction cup to touch the anode. If nothing happens, then it's likely discharged. Otherwise, you might hear a short pop sound when the power discharges. Anyhow, always treat the CRT with extra care, even when you believe it's fully discharged. I will then continue to remove the neckboard, so I can later slide out the mainboard. The latter is secured by many screws. But even after I had removed all of them, or so I believed at least, I realized the mainboard is still stuck and won't move a bit. I eventually glimpsed at something which I thought it was yet another screw, though to get access I had to unlock the entire retainer rail. After removing some of the wiring, I could finally slide away the mainboard far enough to access that hidden screw. And here it is, secured by some hot melt glue. I will use a heat gun to dissipate it. Only then I can unfasten that screw. I didn't do any closer inspection on the neckboard or the caps whatsoever. As I have a full recap kit, I'm about to replace just all capacitors. From the neckboard, this proves no bigger challenge. There's a total of 29 caps on the mainboard. It will take a while to fully replace all of them. To simplify things, I'm keeping track of the ones that I have replaced already. It's a tedious and repetitive task. At least, the mainboard has printed indications on both front and backside to denote the correct polarity orientation of the capacitors. Also pay attention to bend the legs into the correct spacing to reduce tension on both the cap and the PCB once soldered. And eventually, all caps will be replaced. Oh, and by the way, the old caps don't just go into the waste bin. I collect them to have them properly disposed of through a recycling center later on. And then the reassembly rally begins. I remount the PCB to the retainer and slide it back underneath the CRT. Be sure to reconnect all cables you may have disconnected before. As expected, I couldn't fully remember the internal setup of the PSU, so I used my pictures taken before to compare the correct cable wiring. Taking pictures and numbering parts, especially screws, greatly helps in getting things back together again. And yes, finally it's all reassembled and looks like a CRT again. But will it work? So let's give it a try and hope it won't blow yet another fuse. Great, the LED lights up already. If all is well, we should see at least some white noise on the display. Oh yes, and here it comes. Now I'm wiring up the 5150 to see if it actually works altogether. Fingers crossed. That's awesome! There's a cursor appearing. And yes, it looks like it works again. I will have to do some burn-in test, but I do hope it will last with the new caps in place. And this concludes my repair of the 5153 CGA monitor. This was the first time ever I did a full recap on a monitor. This repair hit me totally unexpectedly. It seems that I have to earn my marks very hard on the IBM PC restoration task. The more I touch it, the more appears to fix. I'm overly satisfied with the results, and if you're as excited as I am, then please give me a thumbs up. Next time, I hope to deliver some progress on the tandem floppy drive repair. Subscribe to this channel if you don't want to miss that out. See you next time.